You're gonna have to pick up the pace here, Giraffe, because I got things I gotta do.
So about 14 months ago, the Heart of Africa team got some really exciting news about some of our giraffe.
Zuri is pregnant. Jaina is pregnant.
Okay.
So I'll do around the same time.
Our giraffe herd, we are so lucky to have 14 giraffe. You know, it's kind of unheard of, but it's wonderful because giraffe numbers in the wild have decreased by 40%, and that's scary. So our herd is going to grow quickly, but we're ready.
Zuri should have talked to Jaina before.
Zuri has actually given birth. Everything went flawlessly, beautifully. She had a very easy delivery. He was up and about 40 minutes later and walking around.
Did you see that too?
So we've really been watching Jaina all day just because she's been acting a little different. By that, I mean she's just almost a little irritated. We know that she is right in her birth window. So we are just intentionally watching her and making sure that what we feel is happening is actually happening.
What's the best part about Jaina and her development?
We know she has milk.
Yes.
She's very full.
Very full.
Very full.
Which it's very impressive, to be honest with you. With Zuri, we didn't really see that. It came on as the calf, you know, was here for a few hours or so and it started to let down. But we know Jaina is good to go right now. And now it's that waiting game.
Tired, I'm going to bed.
Just gonna leave me here.
All right, I'm gonna get Connie in position, and then Laura, if you wanna bring up the bench.
Okay.
Connie, chain. We have 6 Asian elephants here at the Columbus Zoo. Connie's our oldest at 45.
Good.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Not on me. Our elephants get an annual exam every year. One thing we noticed with Connie around that time was that her left eye had a little bit of cloudiness.
Good girl.
We brought it up to Priya's attention, and she agreed that she did see some cloudiness there. So Priya asked us to train her for ultrasound. She's actually planning on doing them both, not just the left, to see what they look like. So elephants don't have the best eyesight. They're very large animals. They have very small eyes comparative to their size. And their eyes are kind of set out to the sides a little bit. So their eyesight isn't the greatest. They rely more on their sense of smell to explore their environment. That's why a lot of times when you see them just wandering around, exploring or looking for food, they lead with their trunks. We don't want to jump to any conclusions about what it could or could not be until we're able to actually do the ultrasound. So we're keeping our fingers crossed that there are no cataracts or anything like that. Hopefully just age-related eye issues.
We'll let the water run for a second and then I'll have you do the flashlight, Laura.
Okay.
When I asked Priya what the ultrasound would look like, because obviously we've never done one on an eye before, basically she said that we would have to run a light stream of hose over Connie's eye.
Good girl.
Elephants love water, so we weren't worried about her being hosed or being weird about being hosed, but sometimes when we hose them, they just want to drink it. Connie clothes. Then we moved on to using the end of a flashlight to simulate the ultrasound probe.
Do it again.
She didn't seem to mind at all. So pretty quickly, we just started increasing the amount of time that we made contact with the mock probe.
Good job.
Do it again. Connie clothes. Connie has kind of a special role in our herd. You know, typically the oldest female in a herd is really gonna be the matriarch. She's gonna be the leader. But Connie is not that for our herd. Connie's more of an eccentric, older aunt. She can stir the pot a little bit, cause a little bit of trouble, but that's why I like her so much. I picture myself as her as I get older, as like the kind of sassy older aunt. So maybe I identify with her a little bit, maybe in the future. Let's do one more. I'll try for a little longer. Connie, close. Elephants are very, very smart. In general, they are close to primates in intelligence. And I think she hides it well, but I tell everyone that Connie is one of our smartest.
Good girl. I think that's good.
Connie did really well today. We were able to go through the whole process And I think we're as ready as we're ever going to be. I think Priya's going to be able to come down and do the ultrasound with no problems and be able to diagnose what's going on.
Good job, Connie.
Now, neither one of us are going to be able to see.
So Jaina is still in labor.
She's so good.
Turned around.
At least I'll be able to see if it comes out this side.
Babies and birthing is the most stressful thing in my life. It's a wonderful experience to be part of, but we want to be able to control things, and it's all up to them. So you have to be patient, and I am not patient.
In these pregnancies, you're talking 15 months. You're talking about this whole thing. You're anticipating it. You're, you know, every week we have a meeting.
Pull it up.
Well, can I look at yours? So when it finally comes to, you know, fruition, stop yelling at me. You get a little, you know, giddy and you're excited and you play off of each other.
That's why I just want you ready.
I'm ready.
Okay. Man, everybody, taking a deep breath.
Do I look good in this mask?
I'm coming out here to check on our camel boys. Elmer looks like he's nestled up with the water bowl. That's new. Elmer Fudd and Steve Harrington are Bactrian camels, and they're brothers. Hi, buddies. How you doing? Huh? Oh, I have to hand feed you. You can't eat out of the bucket. Elmer Fudd is 2 years old, and Steve Harrington is 6 months old. And we had to hand raise both. Hi, buddy. You're chewing on a stick. Good job. It's a tricky situation, because if we're hand-raising, it means something's wrong. Ultimately, we want them to be with their parents. We want them to stay with their mother.
Okay, now you're just playing.
But Shushu, the past 3 times now, she has not raised her kids. And it's a difficult situation because Bactrian camels are endangered, and so every single animal is important to the population. So we're gonna do what we can to keep these animals going. And if that means hand-raising, then we'll do it.
You guys will be going to a new home together. I'm so happy you guys are going together.
At the moment, we only have their mom and dad here at the wilds, so there's no breeding opportunity for them here. In order for them to move on with their life and add to the genetic diversity of the population, they'll actually have to go and be a part of their own herd someday.
It's gonna be very sad to see you guys go. Gotten used to coming out and seeing you guys, but I'm excited about your new adventure together.
It's gonna be a sad day when they go because, I mean, just look at them.
Thanks. Right in my face.
Harrington's special because he was born during a pandemic and we normally have more help and we didn't this year. And as much work and as big of a load as that was, it means that I was there for every single step of the way.
You're not supposed to be as tall as me already.
I'm very happy that they're gonna be able to go together. At the same time, I'm sad. These are my boys. I guess I'm one of those people that internalize all of those things and I'll deal with it the day of. I don't know if that's healthy, but I'll shove it down deep and I'll deal with it that day.
You two are some goofy boys.
Up next with these guys, we need to do some pre-shipment exams. So that just means that we need to do a health check, get some blood, make sure that everything's good for them to move on. Bye, boys.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. Here we go. This is a good view.
Oh, God. Did you hear that noise? That was me taking pictures.
We've been waiting all day, and finally, it looks like Jaina's about to give birth. I'm actually surprised at how giddy and excited I am because usually I'm the worrywart, right? I'm always, oh, this is not gonna work. Jaina is a little bit older and she's had calves in the past.
She's a seasoned mom,
but at the same time, she has had a stillborn before.
Can you see on her side?
No.
And you're scared, you know?
Oh, no.
Can we go upstairs and listen?
She deserves to be a mom. She really does.
About 6 o'clock, I was downstairs and you could see the stomach get tight. the tail move to the side, and then she'd be just kind of pace. So we may have number 16 any minute now.
When you think about people getting stressed out about football games and things like that, that doesn't stress me out. This is what stresses me out.
Look.
Oh my goodness, almost there. I see hooves.
Look.
Oh!
Look at that! That is incredible! Jaina, one of our Maasai giraffe, she just had a baby. Oh my gosh, it looks so good already.
This moment is so exciting for us.
She's doing incredible.
You're so invested for so many months. All you want is this calf to be here and to be healthy, and for us to have that is amazing. It's standing up! Sorry, I just yelled in your ear. In giraffe, you know, they're going to be standing within the first hour of life because obviously they've got lions and other predators. But, you know, as you can imagine, they have these gangly legs, and figuring out how to get those to coordinate with one another and actually stand up, it's quite a sight to be seen.
Like, this baby's like, let's get going.
And that's how mom's attitude is too, which is good. Now, next, we need for this little baby to position itself under Jaina and nurse.
That first nutrition is extremely important to a young animal's life. It is how they protect themselves. So it's really important for that baby to find nutrients right away.
Okay, baby's going in, guys. Baby's going in.
All we can do is sit and watch. I want to take it and show it to them and hold. And it's all up to them to make sure it happens.
Look.
This baby's gonna nurse.
Holy crap.
This baby's gonna nurse.
This baby is obviously thriving. It is amazing how quickly this animal stood up, how quickly it's looking for nutrition.
I'm so excited. She's got so much milk.
She has so much milk.
This kid is just check, all the way down the list.
Oh, yeah. We're texting with all the keepers and all kinds of people now, but people have access to these cameras, so we can all enjoy it together.
We were distracted by all these guys.
Welcome to our family, little one. Look at them all greeting them. That's adorable.
Good boy, Tim.
Where's it go? Come on.
Good boy.
What a pig. Ready?
Yeah.
Paint. Close. Today we're gonna be doing some paintings with Randall the Warthog. It's a really fun enrichment behavior. Paint. It's just something that he does as a mental challenge, a way that I can interact with him and teach him something fun.
Hello!
Good. But what's really cool is that we can then take the paintings, sell them to interested members of the public, and then we use that money to buy enrichment for other animals. Good job, Bubba.
Wow.
You can feel the emotion.
It looks like
one.
His hair, you know?
I agree. I really don't know what it was. He and I just kind of instantly established a connection. He's got these amazing eyes, this long Fabio hair. Oh, he's so good looking.
Oh dear. Yep. This one's really splattering.
Oh, wow. He's half the reason I wake up every day, basically. I love that pig. Good.
Now this is what I call a masterpiece.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Look at that one. Pig Casso, some would say. Way to go, Mr. Pig.
Jaina had a calf last night. It's Jaina's eighth calf. Super, super, super exciting. I'm so happy for the team, so happy for Jaina. Everyone's doing really well. So there's giraffe babies everywhere, which is the best feeling and the best thing on the planet.
Lulu at the Wilds had a little boy. Zuri had a little boy. We're waiting to see what Jaina has. It's a really good time for giraffe. It's a really good time for giraffe conservation. And these little guys mean a lot to us.
It's like a superstar. Nursing every hour, laying down, getting up.
You can just feel everyone's happiness and feel everyone's excitement. Good morning. Congratulations. It's always an exciting day whenever I get to come to the giraffe barn, but today is a very special day. Where? Is Shannon in there?
Shannon's at Lions. Have you seen it?
Can I see it?
Oh, yeah.
I did legitimately try and go to speak to Shannon about things that weren't pertinent to the calf, but since Shannon's not there...
Hi, Tina.
Any baby is just wonderful to see. Giraffe babies are one of the cutest babies. Good girl, Jaina Bug. Calf looks wonderful. She's so strong. I totally think it's a girl just because she just looks like a girl. I don't know if you can really like scientifically say that, but to me it looks like a girl. Oh my God, it's so cute.
Yeah, this is, I don't trust you people. Yeah. You do something, my baby.
Jaina is being incredibly protective. It's okay, you don't need to chuff at me. I'm just looking.
Aww.
The minute she sees me, she walks over and, you know, makes sure that the calf is very close to her. We'll probably plan on doing the neonate exam either tomorrow or the day after just to give them a chance to bond. But one of the really important things are getting the vaccine in and sexing that calf to figure out if it's a boy or a girl. I'm excited to find out. The cutest babies.
Go ahead.
Hey, buddy, we're ready whenever you get around here on Tamer.
10-4, I'm on my way now.
Elmer and Harrington are going to be leaving us. They're going to a new home, which means we need to do a pre-shipment exam. And we do pre-shipment exams on any animals that leave to make sure that they're completely healthy before they move on to the next chapter of their lives. Keeps eating like this, I'll have to get more treats.
Camels can be a little stubborn.
Come on, buddy.
Courtney's going to try the soft way of doing it and just using her treat bucket. She has worked a lot with these guys. She's one of the ones that had a main part in hand raising them. So I'm going to go off Courtney's lead here and see if she can't get him to the tamer.
We're coming. Elmer Fudd loves to eat. He will pretty much do anything for food, and that's all he thinks about. He doesn't like the scale. Nope, that's not an option. They're not really used to stepping on anything metal. They're used to being out on grass and dirt. So we do get held up there.
Because you never see anything stubborn like a camel when you get into this situation. He's not digging it. He's being a big baby about it. I don't know if he's afraid of people seeing what he weighs or not. I mean, he's a guy. I didn't think they cared about that, but who knows? Hopefully Courtney can get him over this little hurdle. A little bit of stress fart there. Yeah, take your time.
Yep.
No hustle.
He doesn't like the scale. We know that.
So today, Elmer and Harrington, our little Bactrian camel males, are getting their pre-shipped exams. They're getting ready to take off, go to a new place. It's very important that we get a look at them just to ensure that they're as healthy as they can be.
Nope, nope, you're good.
Come on.
This is your only option, bud.
Yep. 1 foot, 2 foot. Good job.
Courtney does a great job, gets him over that, gets him around the corner.
Got 2 feet in.
Right there.
Is he making you work for it, Coleman?
Patty does the last little push in.
Right. Got him.
To the very end, huh? So with Elmer, he's already in here. He's not very happy.
Elmer Fudd, he does get a little nervous, and you'll hear some things. I don't know. It's just what he does.
You all right there, Cody?
Yeah, I'm good. It just smells.
It's all those fresh treats he just got.
If you're going to get a camel spitting in your face, at least it tastes like apple. That's better than the normal stuff I eat.
Hear him?
Yep.
Okay. We got a TB test. We got our transponder.
Elmer Fudd eats out of the bucket the entire time. It definitely helps with his nerves a little bit.
Done?
Done.
Man, we are done.
And we're able to finish the exam. Everything's a success. Everything looks good. So now we need to move on to Steve Harrington.
You guys want a baby camel? Yeah.
Oh, ready? Right. Can we go in?
Patty let him up in here already.
Nice.
So we just finished it.
We'll probably do this part, like, right there.
With Harrington being so much smaller, Cody and I kind of jump in there, and we actually kind of prop him up on our lap.
That's everything.
So we got our blood.
There we go.
Yep.
The vets get what they need super quick.
So his is all the unmarked tubes.
And he does a lot better than his brother, tell you the truth.
That a boy.
I'm going to be sad to see him go, for sure.
We're home.
But it's going to be harder on Courtney. I mean, these been her boys, and I feel for her in that way.
The bucket is empty.
Okay.
Goes Let's for my shoes.
It's starting to get a lot more real now that I'm not going to be able to just walk over there and see how they're doing, give them some treats.
Oh.
Oh, you okay?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to miss them.
Today, in preparation for Connie's ultrasound on her eye, we're going to go ahead and give her a bath, which is one of my favorite things to do. Ready? During the procedure, we're actually going to be running the hose along her eye so that Priya can get good images of it, so might as well give her a bath.
Ready? She's like, am I ready?
I might be a tiny bit obsessed with pachyderms. Oh, I think so. I have not only a lot of elephant and rhino artwork in my house, but I like a lot of flair in general. So my car has some special flair. I have elephants and rhinos on there along with all my nerdy loves. I love telling people fun facts about elephants. Some of their closest existing relatives in the animal kingdom are manatees, actually. Get some soap going here. We're gonna give her a good scrub on both sides, trunk to tail. Elephants also don't have sweat glands in their bodies except for in their cuticles of their nails.
Ooh, I'm already working up a sweat. What does that say about me?
But when they do sweat, when it's hot out, you'll see dark rings around their nails, and that's because it's actually their cuticles that are sweating.
Connie girl, how you doing? Okay, I think I'm ready to rinse. This is my favorite part.
Ooh, look at that. So satisfying.
So pretty.
It's pachyderms, guys. That's what I love. That's my passion. And I am most likely going to work with them for the rest of my zoo career.
Here she comes. The best part of the bath. Ah, so refreshing. There's just something about that hose water, you know. It's so good. Good job, Connie. You're so clean.
Good girl.
And that's what it's like to give an elephant a bath.
It's a playpen for a baby giraffe.
Yes, we're putting the pack and play together.
It's a huge day here in Heart of Africa. Last night, Jaina gave birth to the most perfect calf, and they are doing wonderfully together. So our focus with them is just to keep them inside the barn and let their bond continue to grow. But now we are going to focus on Zuri and her calf and putting them out to the feeding yard for the first time. So this is it's a pretty great day today.
Okay, I'm opening the gate.
He's just over 30 days old, and this is the next big step for this little guy. This is that first phase that we enter before we get to let him out to bigger spaces and, you know, longer periods of time.
Oh, here we go.
Hi, Zuri. You wanna come out? Hi, little dude. You wanna come out here?
So 30 days is kind of our superstition in the hoofstock world. Like, you kind of are like, well, once he's 30 days, we'll give him a name. Once he's 30 days, we'll do this. Just because the mortality of these animals is so high. So once they hit that 30-day mark, there's a bit of a sigh of relief. You're definitely not out of the woods, but you're one step closer.
Zuri's just checking it out, but she's making just a lap in the holding yards, but she is curious. Come on, Mama. You want some brows? Nope. Come on, Mama, you can do it.
If you are not patient, you cannot be a zookeeper. That is the game. You might have an idea of how things should go. She's got a whole different plan, so we just gotta go with her plan.
at this point and let her work through it and be on her time, because this is a big day for her too. You know, this is her baby. She is supposed to protect this baby.
Zuri's getting close. Good girl, Zuri. Good girl, Mama. Here she is.
Where's the baby?
Here he is. Hi, big guy.
I'm frozen. He's so freaking cute.
Baby giraffe love is the best, most euphoric, silly, light, happy, goofy feeling you've ever experienced. You can't look at a baby giraffe and not just kind of squeal a little bit.
Oh, he says, I don't know. GoPro. Oh, my God.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my God.
Hi, baby.
Hi, little dude.
Hi, big guy. He's doing so good.
Oh, God, he's running.
Oh, my God. I love him so much, Adam.
He's pretty cute.
He's the cutest.
He's the cutest.
Like, what is that?
What's that noise? What? It's him. George is making that noise.
Is he
you hear George?
Out?
Yeah. As we're standing here and we're enjoying the baby being out in this moment with mom, we hear something, you know, kind of off to our left. And as we look out, George, our greater kudu, is snorting and he is walking intentionally to the feeding yard.
George, that's not helpful.
George, you stop right there. Oh, God. Oh my God, all we need is him for to jump a fence.
Today, we are introducing Zuri's calf to our feeding yard.
George is out of control.
And as we look out, George, our greater kudu, he has something to say about this calf.
Okay. Didn't anticipate this. I don't know what his problem is.
We got George when he was a young little kudu, and he's grown up with giraffe. So I'm not sure why he's so obsessed with this baby giraffe. This baby giraffe is no threat to him at all.
I'm gonna go in.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on, but I'm not gonna take a chance with this. I'm gonna run out there and we're gonna stand in between George and the baby, and I'm gonna protect the baby from George.
Are you kidding me with this? George is just like,
you better go.
It's super weird.
The family's after
you
now.
He's causing all the issues.
Look at that.
I think all the giraffes are like, okay, you're done.
Yeah, they're like, be gone.
You've seen enough.
He's fine. Go away.
This herd worked as a team together for one common goal, and that common goal was to protect that baby.
Look at that.
They are literally herding him away.
That is incredible. That's right. Keep it moving, Georgie. Keep it moving.
Oh, wow. Everything is just right. And the baby's out. And the sun just hits him just right. And I can't believe that we're finally here.
No. Are you crying too?
No.
It's hot out here.
It's such a wonderful thing for our whole team because, you know, this year's been hard, you know, with COVID-19 going around, you know, you have ups and downs of emotions. This was really one of those moments where everybody came together and you just embrace the excitement and the joy that he is giving us.
It's time to go inside now. You did great. What a good boy.
That was pretty incredible. I love it. Great job.
Today we are going to attempt an eye ultrasound on Connie, one of our elephants. In December last year, we noticed that she may have a cataract on her annual exam. So ultrasound is a really easy, non-invasive way to try and define that a little bit better, and we'll see how she does today. Cataracts in elephants are exactly the same as cataracts in people. So there is an area of thickening of the lens and it obstructs light going through and that can often lead to visual impairment. There are absolutely many causes of cataracts, but one of the common reasons is an age-related change. So we just want to make sure that Connie does or does not have a cataract, and then how do we treat that or change anything? So let's try doing the affected eye first, the left, and then maybe do the other side.
Sounds good.
Cool.
All right.
There's a lot riding on today in terms of this being a new technique, doing an eye ultrasound that we've never done here at the zoo.
Ready to go?
Yep.
All right. She'll come to it.
Okay.
Over here, please. Okay. Go ahead.
Connie, close.
Dude, that's cold.
Being on that bench, being covered with water, which is something that I forgot happened when I did these ultrasounds.
It's down my shirt.
It really was a huge goosebumps moment for me.
She diverged the streams. Kind of my bad.
Thanks.
We've never done elephant eye ultrasounds here at the zoo because ultimately our elephants are pretty young, pretty healthy, and we haven't had a need to. But I did my master's project on the anatomy of the Asian elephant eye. It was incredible. It was the best experience. We have, you know, 60 animals' eyes, and we were able to determine normal anatomy, but just the experience of going out into their native range, working with elephants of different ages in different situations, and I remember scanning elephant eyes in rivers. I cannot describe how happy I was in that moment in time.
Connie, close.
Yeah, you got it. Cool.
Thank you.
We're able to scan the side pretty easily, and we get some really, really, really amazing images. This is a whole eyeball.
Oh.
This is a cornea. So she definitely has a little bit of thickening of that lens capsule, but I think that's okay in terms of like age.
Right.
But from the elephants I've scanned to look for cataracts in the past, it's been very obvious that they have a cataract.
Gotcha.
So the fact that we're not seeing anything like actually within the lens is important.
Nice. It is a big relief to know that Connie does not have a cataract at this point.
Good news.
Yay for our old lady. Her eye is just aging, so that's something we definitely expect to see. So it's been a huge relief that she doesn't have anything worse going on.
That was awesome.
I'm pretty excited for Miss Connie.
Yeah. Well done, guys.
She's my favorite. Awesome. Don't tell any of the others I said that.
You gotta love the little old lady.
I know.
Little old lady. Good morning.
Hey, everybody.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Good.
So today is Janus Calf's neonate exam. A lot of excitement this morning over the new calf, which is completely 100% appropriate, I will add.
So going into this, we just know that it's going to be potentially a handful.
The neonate exams have a lot of different functions. So it's an important time for us to get our hands on the calf and do a full physical exam, which importantly, lets us find out the gender of the calf.
I think it's a girl.
Boy.
But it's also an opportunity to evaluate the umbilicus, evaluate the mouth, make sure there's no congenital issues, but also give vaccines and get a blood sample to make sure 100% that the calf has appropriate nutrition and no signs of infection.
Let's do it.
This is a pretty tricky process. We need to get mom away from the baby first.
Okay, door shut.
So you gotta be quick, but you gotta be cautious, and then you gotta time everything right.
Oh, I think they said you're set.
Are we going?
Yeah. The name of the game is get in and get out. Adam and Scott enter through the main door. Sherry and Madison come through a back door. It's go time.
Hello. Okay, door shut.
A day and a half ago, Jaina gave birth to a new giraffe calf. So today we've decided to do a neonatal exam on this calf.
Are we going?
Yeah. The name of the game is get in and get out.
Hello, baby. Hello.
Okay.
Okay.
It was perfect.
Okay.
Okay, what do you guys need? Vaccines going in.
Randy and I have split up into two teams. Randy will be placing a microchip, getting a blood sample.
Almost got the blood.
Microchip.
I have the big responsibility of evaluating the gender, making sure I don't get the gender wrong, which seems like it would be very hard to do, but it's always important to double check and then double check again.
It's a girl.
It's a girl.
Hot damn.
Yay.
Cool. She's a she.
Definitely a girl.
Baby Jenna.
Maasai giraffe are endangered, so there are only a few thousand left in their native range. So having any calves born is so important, whether they're male or female. But for us, females are really, really exciting because it means that there's a good chance that she could stay here and potentially breed.
She's got incisors, she's got molars.
No palate issues.
She knows she's in good shape. Ow, she bit me.
Now we are ready to release. And again, this is all about a timing issue. Once she's released, we don't want her to try to run through that door that's closed.
One, two, three.
Blindfold's off. You're okay. You're okay.
Okay, get out.
Whoa. Hang, watch out, Scott.
Open that door. Amy, open the door.
Red. Okay. And I'm getting the hell out because of Jaina. That was great, you guys.
Nice.
The fact that we're here, we're done, we can't be anything but happy.
Little girl.
Little girl.
One of the things I cannot wait for is when baby boy and this little girl meet each other. It's one of the things that we were hoping that we had calves pretty close to each other so they could grow up together. So I cannot wait till that day comes.
It's exciting. Now we have a girl and a boy, a healthy girl. She looks good. She is healthy. She's robust. She put up a reasonable resistance and everything looks good. Beautiful baby girl.
So today, Elmer and Harrington are gonna hopefully get loaded on a trailer to go to their new home. They are going to a place in Wisconsin to live with other camels, and they're going together. So this'll be great for them. Their new life is gonna start, and that's always really exciting. I'm really sad. I'm gonna miss them.
Ultimately, it's a good thing, but it's also very sad. They have a greater purpose in life. So it's too selfish for me to try to hold on to them.
You're gonna get right on the trailer, right? No big drama.
It's finally sinking in that they're not gonna be around anymore, and it is hard. You invest all this time and energy.
Hi.
You just wanted to scratch your nose on me, huh? Just to be a part of the end of their story here at the Wilds is important to me.
Ready when you are.
Okay.
Starting to feel real. It's happening. I'll be able to breathe when we get him on the trailer.
I miss you, buddy.
Ready, big boy?
The plan is for us to just open the door and have them follow me to the trailer.
Come on, boys.
Kurt will be behind him like he usually is. There needs to be any motivation from behind, but I'm hoping we don't need that.
Elmer's helping push Harrington.
Elmer has some experience with trailers, but Harrington has none. Luckily, his brother is behind him and gives him a push.
Come on.
All right, good. Shut that one behind Elmer.
Surprisingly, Elmer, he does pause for a little bit.
Come on, Bubby. Come on, think
good
about
boy.
It.
Good boy, come on.
Step get up in there.
Good boy.
But eventually, boy. You know, he just steps right on the trailer. It's the easiest he's ever gotten on a trailer.
I think we're good.
Good?
Mm-hmm. Okay. You can tell Courtney's starting. She's being tough because she's Courtney. She's tough, but it's hitting.
He's secure.
She's had them since they were babies. I mean, she took care of them from when they were just wee little, and we had to pull them from Shushu.
Bye, buddy.
I don't know, I feel for her. Like, you have to care to do what we do, and this is the downside of it.
Be good. Be good. I'll miss you.
It's starting to get a lot more real now that we have him on the trailer. That's one of the great things about the job is these success stories, and I definitely consider these two success stories, and I wish them all the best.
He's looking. This is the worst part.
Well, it's good seeing you, Matt.
Good seeing you.
Thanks for taking these boys.
Yep.
Be good. I'll miss you.
This is definitely a difficult part in hand raising because eventually they're not gonna stay with you. At least if they're going out in pasture, you get to see them still. But with Elmer and Harrington, it is a little harder because they're leaving. So although I feel very proud and very happy, it's also very sad.
I hate when he's looking.
Why is this emotional for you?
I don't know, you spend so much time and energy on him and
I mean, this is what it's about, so the success, and they're gonna live on and contribute to their species, which is in trouble, and it's a very bright future for them. I'm very, very happy I got to be a part of it.
It's been a great couple of years. You can't ask for a happier ending. Oh, I'll never forget Elmer and Harrington. They're gonna live here in the heart for the rest of my life.
Oh my goodness, Connie! I am here to check in on Connie. I feel really, really happy, very, very relieved that Connie doesn't have a cataract at this point. Now, we can continue to monitor her very frequently to make sure she doesn't develop a cataract as she gets older. I've always loved elephants. I've dreamed about elephants since I was like 7 years old.
Little Sunny, little Rudy.
They're so incredible. They are the world's biggest terrestrial megavertebrate.
Boop, 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 boop.
It's so special being able to see them. They're just magical, magical beasts. Very lucky, lucky to have them here.
It's a big day.
How excited are you, Adam?
Super excited.
Super excited. Today's the day. We are going to let our new little lady meet our other calf, who's just a couple months older than her. We're gonna let them have their first play date.
Hi, Dana Bug.
Getting these two calves together, I think is probably gonna be one of the cutest things I've ever seen.
Oh boy.
Oh my God, here we go. Oh, I gotta take
this. Hi, Z.
Oh my God.
Hi, little man.
Some of the things that we want to see is an interaction between the calves. That's very important. Also, positive interactions from the moms to the opposite calves.
I can't even. Oh, Zuri. What a nice baby. Whoa.
Good girl, Zuri.
We see positive interaction from the word go. Zuri goes over and sniffs the little girl, and the little girl, you know, responds sweetly.
You're a cute one.
Yeah, you're little.
Aww. Yeah, Jane is like, thanks for babysitting. I'll see you at about 2:30. Yeah,
so. Go say hi to him.
Finally, we see the little boy approach her.
Go on, in.
Go
interact.
Play.
She kind of ignores him in the beginning, right? So she turns her head like, ugh, just a boy.
First contact.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
That's adorable.
There we go.
Finally, she does acknowledge them, and you start seeing the nuzzling and the following.
Oh.
God, they're cute.
Oh my gosh, look how little she looks compared to him.
What we're seeing is absolutely just beautiful to watch.
Oh.
Baby girl's like, holy, what are you? And it causes chaos and running and zooming and it, not unexpected.
Ooh.
Oh God,
here we
go. Oh God, we're running.
Hilarious.
I love when they run around and zoom around. It is a little nerve-wracking when they're this young and this important to us, but it's fun to watch.
All fours. Oh. See, she's real good on that concrete.
Seeing them together, it's so cute.
Oh.
We're not friends. They kind of zoom around the community room and just really enjoy each other.
Oh, oh, oh.
See, she's fine. Look at that.
Oh my God,
look
I just
that.
Puked a little.
We're gonna go ahead and end it right now. She seems like I'm done for the day.
Another milestone in both of these calves' lives, another milestone for us because we've never done this before.
Get out of here, Jana's on duty. Good luck.
Jana's like, I guess I'm on duty now. Everybody got along, everybody had some fun, everybody was safe.
She kisses everyone on the face.
Mm-hmm. It really was the perfect play date.